Welcome to another bonus episode of My Friend Gateway. So what we're going to do here is we're going to play, like, super exhaustively the trivia game that Nubo wants us to play. So the casino is surprisingly well equipped, and we've read all that. Nubo Camelian is wearing a medallion. So we're going to play the game. So the way the game works is that it's got four kind of topics, which is all the trivia, history and geography, art and entertainment, science, engineering and nature, games of all kinds. I will end up going with a science, engineering and nature run through, which I will edit in. Oh, no one wants to see that cursor. It should get out of the way. Anyway, so we're going to run through, like, exhaustively 1, 2, 3, and 4, and I'm going to show you all the paths that you can take. So we're going to start off with our friend history and geography, simply because it is the first. Okay, 1, historic blunders. Now the other thing is that this game, a lot of the stuff that's in here is all just kind of made up for Gateway, the game. So if you don't recognize any of this, don't be alarmed or surprised, because it's not all factually correct. After his election as President of the United States in 1996, he accidentally launched a nuclear strike on the unsuspecting resort island of Rwanda, the Itok, vaporizing 65 natives, 40 visiting tourists, 3 sailboats, and a small cruise ship. Who is he? So, as you can see, there are people here. George Bush, surprisingly, is in there, but the answer is not George Bush, because no one knew that it was going to be George Bush in 1996, so that we got Danforth Quayle as the answer. Okay. World capitals. What was the capital of India before it was moved to Greater Bombay in early 2023? As you can see, we're not in 2023, so there you go. So that is New Delhi. Weapons. Too terrible to use. The use of technical nuclear weapons for the first time in 60 years turned this otherwise unremarkable regional conflict into a historic watershed. Hint, the weapons were purchased from disaffected Soviet army units soon after the break of the USSR. We got the Vietnam War, the invasion of Kuwait, the War of the Orchard between Chile and Argentina, and the Second Iran-Iraq War. And the answer there is 4. Yes. State capitals. What is the state capital of the U.S. state? Southern California. Hint, the capital of Northern California is Sacramento. So we are at 4, and the answer for that is San Diego. Countries of the world. What was the name of the African People's Republic before the first elected black government changed the country's name in the last decade of the 20th century? We got Zaire, Rhodesia, South Africa, and Mali. That would be 4. Really? Oh, sorry, I got that wrong. Oh, I was looking at the wrong answer. Oh, it might just be wrong, because mine's listed as 4. Must have taken that down wrong. This cosmopolitan French-speaking city was 3-time capital of a country by the same name, which seceded from Canada in 1995, was re-annexed in 2011, seceded again in 2022, was re-integrated into Canada in 2026, and seceded the last time in 2030. So that is 1, which is Quebec. Environmental history. The infamous North American ozone hole appeared some 4 years after it was predicted by a group of prominent scientists. It became a serious campaign issue during the US election here, 1980, 1996, 2004, 2008. Sorry, that's 1988. That's difficult to read. This is 7, and the answer there is 2. Dinosaurs. Who was the last leader of the defunct... What? Oh, okay. That's not very nice. Who was the last leader of the defunct Union of Soviet Socialist Republics? We got Boris Yeltsin, Yuri Andropov, Andrei Chekhov, and Mikhail Gorbachev. That would be 4. Dinosaurs Part 2. This region of the world became increasingly important to industrialized nations between 1945 and 2020, and then suddenly reverted to third world backwater status in less than 5 years. Hint, they became dinosaurs because they ran out of them. The Middle East, the Pacific Rim, Central Africa, and Central America. That's such an awkward way to phrase this, but it's one. This is also stereotyping to the nth degree. Offbeat historical facts, the United Kingdom went to war with the what South American country during the early 1980s. We got Brazil, Peru, Chile, and Argentina, and the answer there is Argentina. You answered 9 out of 10 questions correctly. Thank you. Okay, I'm not going to read this. No one read this because this is spoilers. We're going to go back in and we're going to start from scratch. Okay, so this is the second thing that we have here is art and entertainment. Music fads. Oh, wow. Okay. The rap music phenomenon that dominated the 1980s, 1990s, and the late 2020s after resurgence was most closely associated with environmental concerns, a rebuke of rural life in the American Midwest, the men's rights movement, and life in U.S. black urban communities. That is probably going to be 4. Again, stereotyping to the nth degree. That's terrible. Academy Awards. Susie Santini won an Oscar for Best Actress in this stunning 2004 motion picture about day-to-day existence in the decaying urban shell of New York City. Wetware, A Woman and an Apple, The Scientist and the Poet, Night Falls at the End of the World. Actually, The Scientist and the Poet is a nice name for something. And the answer there is 2, A Woman and an Apple. That's a terrible name as well. Music fans, part 2. The musical group 10 Dead Bananas recorded this rock and roll smash hit about the abuse of direct neural interfaces in 2010. Chemical Dreams, Matrix Overdrive, Third World Going Nowhere, and Wirehead. And I'm going to assume the answer is Wirehead. I am correct. Old movies about real life. Jean-Paul Bardot's 10-hour cinema variety study of a nuclear accident cleanup effort was filmed on the site of his 2007 disaster. Of this 2007 disaster, the core explosion of Mauritius, the Chernobyl meltdown, the Three Mile Island incident, and the Hiroshima reactor excursion. This is 4. It looks like the answer is 1. All made up stuff, of course. Broadcast media. The first commercial broadcasting success in the new Holotank Tri-V medium was this 2027 sitcom series about elderly baby boomers. Crossover Sons and Daughters, done in 2030. 70-something. It's probably going to be 70-something. 5. And this is very difficult to look at because I got to trace lines and I'm not doing it correctly. Oh, the answer is 1. Crossover. Oh, that's incorrect. I probably didn't draw a correct line. This Picasso painting of the rear view of his mistress fetched a record all-time high of $356 million from a Japanese collector at a Sotheby's auction in 2041. Interchange Le Mureur, Noces de Perrette, and Moulin de la Galette. Moulin de la Galette. Okay, so that's 6. And I'm going to get this wrong again, I can tell, because I'm not going to line these up correctly. Looks like 2. Okay, good. The Forgotten Players Department, Les Miserables, premiered in the 1980s and maintained a steady popularity on and off Broadway in the face of harsh criticism through 2012. This musical extravaganza was about exploited grape pickers in southern France, the agony of apartheid in South Africa, the French Revolution, urban unrest in Paris in 1943. I do not know anything about Les Miserables because I am not a guy who goes to the theater. So, there we go, it's 3. Weird Art and Architecture Movements, the Anti-Pope. post-postmodernism reconstructionist return to Bauhaus movement in architecture embraces a return to the old international style, best exemplified by the organic melted look of Toronto city center, the sleek flowing lines of 250-story Trade Needle in Chicago, the Baroque elaborate, what? Oh, the Baroque elaborately ornate Pasca Theatre in London, and the austere luxury boxy. That's a weird way to put it. Austere boxy story, 100-story Tom Marco Tower in Kansas City. That will be 8, and it looks like 4. Good stuff. 3V, which is obviously a TV type, the popular 2032 3V production of Childhood's End was based on a novel by the same name, written in the 20th century by Arthur C. Clarke, Larry Niven, H.G. Wells, and Isaac Asimov. That would be 1. Okay, 3V part 2. Sirako Ishikawa remade this 20th century Japanese classic film, retelling the story of King Lear as a full 3B feature for $500 million in 2023. Dreams, Heaven and Earth, Rand, the Terracotta Warrior. It is 3, which is Rand. Right, now it's going to bail me out. Again, don't read, spoilers. Okay, so older trivia, we're going to go with science, engineering, and nature. NASA's Polly. What NASA project was finally completed in 2009 after nearly a decade of schedule slips, 350,000 engineering changes, $150 billion in cost overruns, 2 fatal space shuttle accidents, and 6 agency reorganizations? It would be Earth Observation Systems, Space-Based Materials and Processing Facility, Space Station Freedom, and permanent manned lunar base. The answer is 3. Hats, sunscreens, and full masks. Predictive ozone, now severely depleted, is concentrated in this layer of the Earth's atmosphere. We got troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and the answer is 2. At the end of which geological period did the dinosaurs become extinct? Devonian, Carboniferous, Jurassic, and Cretaceous. I could never say this word. Cretaceous. And the answer is 4. The one I can't say. Man-made wonders of the world. What was the tallest building in the world at 272 stories, surpassing the Sears Tower in the same city, until the Ozark Commerce Tower was built in 2030? We got the Trade Needle in Chicago, the Xi'anian Bank headquarters in Hong Kong, the Singapore Government Center, and the World Financial Tower in Atlanta. That would be 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4, it's 1. Okay, so man's return to manned exploration. The combined NASA JSA ESA and Russia Mars landing project put a man on Mars on the 50th anniversary of man's first visit to Earth's moon. We got 2019, 2009, 2029, and 2031. If you can add, this one's not too hard. it would be 4. No, that's not right. I can't possibly write. Oh well. Yeah, that can't be right. I'm just reading off my list, and my list is wrong sometimes. Artificial life. The first true artificial life form was born in a Cray 2000 optical supercomputer in the Spam State 75 years after James Watson announced his discovery of the double helix of DNA. May 22, 2002, April 3, 2020, December 14, 2039, and August 5, 2053. Now let's not do it again because I got it wrong, so this is 6. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It says it's 3. Maybe that's right. Good. Okay. So, our solar system, what is the surface of the sun called? Corona, photosphere, core, or solar flare? Today, and English is hard. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It thinks that it is 2. Okay, good. What star is commonly known as the North Star? Alpha Centauri, Aldebaran, Procyon. I don't think I'm saying that correctly. It's Procyon, probably. And Polaris. That would be for Polaris. Sometimes I know these, sometimes I don't. What would... the ellipsoid pool puzzle. Now, for this one to understand this one, you should probably draw it. But what would happen if a diver came off of a 10-meter diving tower and made a splash in one vertex of a perfectly ellipsoid swimming pool? There would be no splash, the ripples would be intensified, and would crack the bottom of the pool. Another splash would happen in the second vertex, and nothing unusual would happen. As far as I understand it, this is 3. And I don't know if that is real or not. I don't know if you could draw it out and work it out like that, but anyway, where biotech really took off. Biotechnology finally evolved as a major force for change in the world after this landmark event in the early 21st century provided a map for human DNA. Discovery of the DNA molecule, the synthesis of RSX, the cure for AIDS. That's not at all true, I don't think. It's probably not true. Because we don't have a cure for AIDS yet, so it can't possibly be true. The development of polymerase chain reaction tests, completion of the Human Genome Project. It is 4. Again, don't look. Oh, it's a 9 out of 10. I'm going to keep getting 9 out of 10. That's terrible. Okay. So, we have games of all kinds. The gridiron. In the gladiator sport of American football, how many points would your team get for sacking an opposing team's quarterback on his own ensign? I love that he's all in quotation marks. The assumption there is no one plays this anymore, which is good, because it's a silly game. Sorry, Americans, I've just offended you. Oh, that's 2, 3, 1, and 6, and the answer is 2. Double Darren Trevier. When the flitz aligns with a cleave in a game of double Darren, how might your opponent counter the inevitable right given a glove advance? See, this is it. I don't know. Who knows? This is not a real game. Outward clutch, dribbling the cleave, slamming the groove, a forward glove sweep. It is 2. Soccer facts. What soccer team won the 2021 World Cup for the first time in a stunning upset over El Salvador, Argentina, Spain, United Kingdom, and the United States? It's probably going to be the United States, and it is. Surprise. A blast from the past. The word Atari made its way into the collective consciousness of the American public during the late 20th century. This word comes from what Japanese parlor game? Totori, Keiretsu Monopoly, Red Sun Squares, and Go. And the answer is 4. Knight moves. You and your opponent follow a classical opening called Queen's Gambit Declined. What game are you playing? You're playing chess. 5-1. Yes, it's chess. Checkers, strategy plus, or Laser Star is chess. Land of the Wireheads. The virtual reality game Combat, marketed by Paramount Interactive Media, is distinguished by what technological advances? Multiplayer participation, dynamic terrain and scenario generation, computer-generated opponents that learn from their mistakes, and all of the above. I want to say it's 4, because that makes the most sense in 1990 when this was made. So, 4? Yeah. The old national pastime. You're up to bat in a game of baseball. The count is 2 strikes and 3 balls. The pitcher winds up, throws, and the ball hits you in the shoulder. Ouch! What happens? Strike 3, you're out. You walk to first base. Home run! Foul ball. That seems like it would be foul ball. 7. Except I'm wrong, I think. I walk to first base? Really? That can't be right. Hold on. We're in 7. Oh, really? You do? How confusing. Anyway, that seems like a foul ball to me. I don't know about these things. I don't play sports. Sorry. Okay, quarters and joysticks. The most popular games of all time have been interactive computer games, delivered through direct neurocortical stimulation. What were the primitive visual only predecessors of these games called when they were introduced in the 70s and early 80s? Party games, Pax Machine, coin op arcade games, and videotext services systems. That would quite obviously be coin op arcade games. Oh, I'm right. Yay! The Olympic Games. Oh dear. The Olympic Decathlon consists of the following events. Now, this is something that I might have known if I paid more attention, but I don't. Okay, so we've got 100 meter run, 200 meter run, 400 meter run, 3000 meter street chase, steeple chase, 400 meter hurdles, shot put, high jump, javelin throw, discus throw, and triple jump for one. 100 meter run, long jump, shot put, high jump, 400 meter run, 100 meter hurdles, discus throw, pole vault, javelin throw, 1500 meter run. We've got 100 meter run, triple jump, shot put, 10,000 meter run, high jump, 110 meter hurdles, javelin throw, discus throw, pole vault, hammer throw. And we got 1 mile swim, 6 mile run, 26 mile bike trip. Now, you can immediately throw away four because there aren't. A decathlon is, I think, 10. You can throw away four, which probably leaves you with two, but let's check. One has got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That has 10 in it. So this is a trick thing then. So it will be 2. Because it probably has 2 but in a different order. Tennis. If you're playing tennis and the score is deuce after you win... If you're playing tennis and the score is deuce after you won the point on your opponent's last serve, you are ahead of your opponent, behind your opponent, within a point of a touchdown, and tied with your opponent. That is obviously tied. Yay, I got all 10 correctly. I might just save this game with that. Newbar says, congratulations, Newfish. I'm going to read this to you again, because I'm going to plonk this at the beginning of the actual episode on... We're on Friday. So don't worry if you aren't listening and have not been paying attention, because we'll win a game and I'll plunk that at the beginning of the actual episode where we play. But here we go. Numa says, congratulations, Newfish, as he hands over the medallion, then grins as he pulls another one out of his pocket. Got hundreds of these things, he says wickedly. The corp never took them away because they think they are worthless. He hangs the medallion around his neck. Perhaps I will see you around again, my friend. And Numa disappears and your score goes up by 15. And that's it. I will see you for the actual episode on Friday. Remember, on Friday, there will be a bit of this, and then the actual episode will happen. I just wanted to record this to be completely 100% showing you everything that the game has to offer. Anyhow, I will see you guys around. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lost Wolf. This has been an extra episode of Gateway. Have a great 2 days, folks, and I shall see you soon. Goodbye.